What's up, Christ kids? Great to see you today. Yeah, we're glad you're joining us. We'll get started when the countdown gets to zero. See you in a little bit.
Welcome back to Grace Kids TV. My name is Nikki Jessic, and I serve as our Minister of Outreach here at Grace Church. Hi, Grace Kids. Welcome back to Grace Kids TV. My name is Nikki Jessic, and I serve as the Minister of Outreach here at Grace Church. Obviously, I'm not at Grace Church today, but I'm at our beautiful Beulah Beach. We're so excited to have you joining us for Grace Kids TV. After many years, Abraham and Sarah finally had their son Isaac, just as God had promised. Then one day, God asked Abraham to do something really hard to show how much he trusted God. What happened next showed just how strong Abraham's faith was. We'll learn much more about that in just a little bit. We're so glad that you're joining with us today, and we hope you enjoy today's story and that it encourages you to trust Jesus no matter what. Let's get started.
because you're just so full of grace. Looking forward to the day when we will finally see your face. We got the hope of heaven. We got unstoppable eternal life. The hope of heaven. Forever we're alive in Jesus Christ. There's no one marvelous as you. You blow them all away, it's true. Making all things new. We just can't wait till we see you. We got the hope of heaven. We got unstoppable eternal life. The hope of heaven. Forever we're alive in Jesus Christ.
Here we go.
2, 4, 6, 8. Who do we all celebrate? He's the one we elevate.
It's Miss Kelly, and you may be wondering, what's with the Rams? Well, they're very important to our Bible story this week, so I have a game for you guys to play with them. We're going to take these Rams, and we're going to hide them. There's only one per classroom, so you're going to take one Ram, hide it somewhere in the room while everybody else closes their eyes. Maybe your teacher will do it, or maybe you guys can take turns doing it, but you're going to hide it somewhere in the room, and then everybody's going to try and find it. And first person to find it gets to take a turn hiding it. All right, and play that a couple of times to get us ready to hear the Bible story this week. And then I will see you back here next week. Have a great Sunday, and I'll see you later. Bye, Grace Kids.
Many years passed while Abraham and Sarah waited for God's promise to come true. At the right time, God kept his promise, and Abraham and his wife had a son named Isaac. One day, God tested Abraham so that he could show just how much faith he had in God.
God said, "Take your only son Isaac, whom you love, and offer him as a burnt offering on a mountain. And I will show you." Abraham obeyed God. He got up early, saddled his donkey, and gathered wood for the burnt offering.
He set out with Isaac and his servants toward the mountain God had spoken of. When they arrived at the mountain, Abraham had Isaac carry the wood, and Abraham carried the knife and the fire. Isaac asked, "My father, where is the animal for the burnt offering?"
Abraham said, "God himself will provide the lamb for the offering, my son." Abraham was about to sacrifice his son when God stopped him. The angel of the Lord called to Abraham and said, "I see that you fear God and will not even withhold your only son."
Abraham then saw a ram caught in the thicket that God provided for the burnt offering. Abraham named that place, "The Lord will provide." God saw Abraham's great faith because he was willing to give up his only son.
God promised again, "I will bless you and make your family as numerous as the stars in the sky and the sand on the seashore. All the nations of the earth will be blessed through your family."
Abraham was willing to give his only son for God, but God provided another way. God was willing to give his only son for us. Jesus knew there was no other way to save God's people, so he died and rose again to provide them with forgiveness and life with God forever.
Is your first chance to memorize this unit's memory verse. Good luck. 3, 2, 1, go. Time's up. For the next few rounds, we'll gradually take a few words away to see if you can still remember the entire memory verse. Use your friends and teachers to solve the missing words in the memory verse. Good luck. 3, 2, 1, go. Nice job. Now this time we're going to take even more words away. Let's see how you do. Good luck. 3, 2, 1, go. Stop. This time, we're taking even more words away. Help each other out and see if you still remember the entire Bible verse. Good luck. 3, 2, 1, go. Stop. Get ready for the next round. Keep it up. 3, 2, 1, go. Stop. Get ready for the next round. We're taking even more words away this time. Let's see how you do. Good luck. 3, 2, 1, go. Alright, Grace Kids, this is our last round. Let's see how you do. 3, 2, 1, go. Way to go, Grace Kids.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Kevin. It's time for questions from kids. Charlotte from Greensville, South Carolina asks,
why did God send his own son to die on the cross for our sins?
That is a fabulous question. The answer to that question is something that every believer must remember and every unbeliever must hear. God has rules, or laws, or standards. God's rule is that no one should sin, and the consequence for sinning is that someone or something must take the punishment for sin. For example, your teachers or parents have rules. When those rules are broken, there are consequences. Maybe you miss a special treat or lose time doing something fun. When we break God's rules, the consequence is much, much bigger. We are separated from Him forever. The good news is that God sent Jesus to take the consequence of our sin and make it possible for us to live with Him in heaven for eternity. God sent His own Son because He loves us. God sent His Son because He wants us to spend eternity with Him in heaven forever. So we should tell others of this good news. Who can you share the good news of the gospel with this week? I would love to hear from you. If you have a question, email me at gospelproject.kids@lifeway.com, and next time I might be answering a question from you.
Welcome to Spot the Difference. In just a moment, you'll see two images side by side. Your goal is to spot the three differences in the images. Ready? Let's begin. Round one. Can you spot the three differences? Thank you.
time's up. Let's reveal the three differences. Round two. Can you spot the three differences? Time's up. Did you spot those three differences? Round three. Time's up. Let's reveal the three differences. Round four. Time's up. Did you spot those three differences? Round five. This is the last one. Can you spot the three differences? Time's up. Let's reveal the three differences. Great job. Thanks for playing.
All right, Grace Kids. It's time for today's question for the car. Read this question and talk about it with your teacher. Then, on your way home after church, ask the adult in your car this question to see if you can stump them. Your teacher can help you answer any question you may have as well. Let's check it out. Don't forget to ask this question to an adult on your way home today to see if you can stump them. Then next Sunday, you can let your teacher know if they knew the answer or not. We'll see you next Sunday for our next question for the car. Have a great day, Grace Kids.
Hey, Grace Kids. Thanks so much for joining us for Grace Kids TV today.
Yeah, we had a lot of fun.
If today was your first time joining us for Grace Kids, we would love to connect with you and your family to say hi.
For sure. If this was your first time joining us, have a family member scan the QR code with their phone once it comes up on the screen so we can connect with your family.
Now, before we head out, let's bow our heads and pray.
Lord, first we want to thank you for bringing us together with our friends and our teachers today. We pray that our friends who watch Grace Kids TV can share what they learned with their friends and family as they leave church today. Thank you for another opportunity to learn more about you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
We hope you have a great week, Grace Kids. We'll see you next Sunday.
See you next week.